Morning! So a little bit more of an interesting day today. A bit more of an interesting day because we're going across the, don't know if you can see the sign there, but of Aberfeldy, which is a hike. I am dressed for the occasion with my oh-so-snazzy boots on. And yeah, gonna go and see some, supposed to be some good views, I think. Should take me an hour and a half, according to the information booklet that I've got. But yeah, we're gonna go walking, and the rain's held off. It's not yet rained today. It's all dry underfoot and everything, so I'm hopeful. Because I've got another hike planned for later today. So, although I'm a bit later than I planned getting home. So straight away we have this gorgeous little creek or river. I'm not quite sure what it is, I think it's a river. How cute. Oh, and some forestry. Both sides of me is forest. And yeah, it looks like we're going to do a massive nature walk today. So these here are some of the types of plants, exotic plants apparently, that you can find in and around the nature walk here. So if you see any, pop it in the comments, tell me what I saw. I won't know. So I'm not too sure which way I should be going. There's actually no signposts around, so I'm just going wherever really. Picked a route, just going to stick and follow the path. I'm going to try and do the whole circuit today. It should take me an hour and a half-ish. It's about 3 kilometres, I think. But I'm not going to rush around. It's more than achievable in a day. Got a longer walk to do later if I get round to it. Not, I can do that on another day. And I've still got a day spare, so I might do that another day. It's a pretty little river running along beside me there. It's so peaceful. And although there's other people around, it's not busy. It's not overcrowded or anything. It's lovely. Really nice, picturesque, calming nature walk today. So, I've discovered part of the history of the Birks of Aberfeldy, which is where I am at the moment on my lovely little walk, is kept as it was, and it's inspired quite a bit by a poet that came here and sat here and wrote a poem all about this lovely spot. And there he is. So this is the lovely gentleman. I will post the name here because I can't remember what he's called. Sorry, dude. So this lovely poet here, he sat here writing away. He wrote a poem all about the natural area that we're in at the moment. And I can see why. It's absolutely stunning. This is the view we're looking at. So he sat here and he was inspired by nature and he wrote this whole lovely poem. Also found out that birks is actually, I think it's Scottish, for birch trees. So where they spell it B-R-I-K-S, birks, we in England spell it B-I-R-C-H, birch. So yeah, fun fact of the day, can't say you don't know. So I'll leave you to your writing, mate, and we'll carry on our little walk. So it turns out I was wrong. He was called Robert Burns, the bloke we met down there, our poet. And as it says here, the seat here, naturally found in the rock, sit on here, So it was this spot here, naturally in the rock, that he sat and wrote his poem. So spin it round and you can have a look. So this is the view that inspired the poem, The Birds of Aberfeldy. I don't think originally this was all here. And although it's not great from the seat, it's probably good for writing, but it's not great for view. If you look down here, see the river again. And now we've got some more rather windy steep path. Carry up on round the gorge. Literally two steps and you can see this amazing waterfall. I thought the river seemed nice, but I didn't quite know it was a waterfall until I stepped round the corner. So pretty. And I don't think you're supposed to take that path. That's a lot of stairs. So here we have another gorgeous waterfall, but right in front of it, from the corner, we have a lovely passage from the poem that was written here. This is the brave ascend like lofty wires, the foaming stream, deep roaring fires. Around the fragrant spreading shores, the Birds of Aberfeldy. Decisions, decisions, what do we do? I think we'll head off on the nature trail.
So I've been a little bit naughty. I ventured off of the main path. It's just through
there.
Followed this little dirt track. And I've come to a little stream. I don't know if you can see it, you can't really see it. Yeah, a little stream down there. It's pretty. But yeah, as you can see, I am in the middle of a forest right now. It's really pretty. This nature trail is lovely. I don't know what any of the nature is, but it's pretty. I'll come back out with a little duck under all sorts of trees and bits. Yeah, I came through some trees I probably wasn't supposed to. And back And the path should be on, a little bit more maintained, a little bit more stable. Ooh, wow. Okay, right. Are you ready for this? There's a lovely, lovely view as I've just come around the corner. My God. So pretty. And it won't focus. See, I don't know if you can see that in the distance there. All that lovely island there. Just so that's just a little viewpoint in the middle of all this woodlands. The river is down there, the big river that I've been filming as I've been going along. It's a bit rocky underpath. Let me make my way down here. See it. No, I don't know if you can see the river. Yeah, there's loads of little scenery stops. If I stop for everything, it'll take me like 3 hours to just film everything, and it's only like an hour walk. So I'm just showing you the highlights, the best little bits. And I have to say, hills here are worse than in France. Worse than the Pyrenees right now. Here we have a wild pigeon in its natural habitat. It's a rather rare Scottish pigeon that I'm going to call Kevin. Hey Kevin, you alright? Kevin doesn't want to talk today, sorry. No, don't want to talk. All right, see you later, Kev. So this nature walk is a lot more nature, a lot less river, a lot less Birks of Aberfeldy side of thing. Literally it's across on the other side is the other walk I did, but yeah, this one's a lot more trees and a lot further from the river. But I've just stopped here because it's actually the first point I came back in contact with the river after quite a while of walking, just trees, nature. You can hear the river like very faintly in the background, but it's really relaxing because it just, you can probably tell, it drops off like this. And it just goes peaceful, so you just have, as you saw, Kevin, birds and things cheeping. It's more sort of that sort of nature than the rivery side of things, and to get a nice mix along this whole route. It's a big circle, so they merge into one another. Oh my God, sorry, this is my hippie side, you'll have to indulge me. There's a fairy door in that tree. Some little mushrooms outside. Some fairies! Little fairies! Little Scottish fairies. Oh, that's made me happy. It's not very often you see a door like that, but it's lovely. So there we go, that was the Birks of Aberfeldy walk. So that's this morning done. I'm gonna head back now and just see the river a little bit. I'm gonna head back now and get some lunch. It's taken me just an hour and 10 minutes to walk that. It's at an hour and a half, so I'm quite impressed. I managed to do that. I wasn't rushing, I wasn't trying to do it quickly, but I managed to do it really quite quickly. Yeah, that's all good. So yeah, head back,
grab some lunch from the apartment, well, my little cottage, and then head out, I think, for another hike this afternoon. So I've had my lunch and it's taken me way longer than it should have. I haven't headed back out yet because my GoPro was playing up the other day. It wouldn't film more than like a minute's worth of footage. As I was coming home, sort of on the road trip home, we discovered that it just didn't want to work. I fixed it. My lovely laptop on here, and I've actually managed to fix it. So problem was when I was plugged it in or put the memory card in, and it was like no files to import. I thought that's brilliant, there shouldn't be, I've downloaded it all already. And then it goes, but the memory card's full. So, great. How do I fix that if there's nothing on it but it's full? But through pressing a few buttons and a little bit of help from Google, it's all good to go. So thankfully that means I can take it with me on my walk this afternoon. So I'm gonna get myself together, get ready, and we'll head out and do that. So I can't actually film because my phone battery and phone camera's not brilliant. So actually, it means I can actually film something and get some better sort of wide shots of some of the scenery. So yeah, impressed with myself today. We're on our second hike of the day, and we are going to the Drummond Hill Walk. Now it looks like we've got plenty of routes to pick from. How far do we want to walk? I think we'll do this one. Like 2 hours or 4 hours? Yeah, we could do 4 hours. I don't seem to walk as slow as they do on these guides, so I think we'll do 4 hours. Okay, so I got part of the way, about 15 minutes on this walk, hike, whatever you want to call it. Fairly decent path, we'll call it a walk for now. And as predicted, the weather, skies have just opened. I don't know if you can tell, but it is raining currently around me. So I don't think I'm going to do the big long walk that I was going to. Partly not just because of the rain, but I'm obviously allergic to something, one of these plants around here, because my nose is so stuffy I cannot breathe properly. So I'm going to go up, finish, because we're doing the blue walk that goes into the grey walk. So I'm going to finish the blue walk, go to the viewpoint, and then I think I'm going to call it a day at that, because I just don't feel very well, and I don't want to make myself ill and then not being able to enjoy the rest of the week. So I'm going to carry on wandering in the rain up to the viewpoint, see if we actually see anything from the viewpoint because of the weather, and then head back, I think. So there we're at the viewpoint, Black Rock viewpoint. Now this should take us a look out over Loch Tay, I think it's called. So you can start to see it through the trees there. There's the viewpoint. Ooh, there's the bench. Told a little bit of a fib. I've come further up on the walk, and I'm assuming I'm following the right path because there's no proper things, but there keep being these little things with little balls on them, and I'm assuming that's the path I'm supposed to be following to take this route.
because it didn't say on the sign, it just said grey, so I'm assuming that the little grey circles with boars in, it's the grey route. I'm trying to use logic here. Right, so this looks like a good place for a view. That's what I've just walked down through, and this is where we're going to carry on heading. So yeah, there's some really absolutely gorgeous scenery around here. I just sat there and was thinking, bloody hell, Scotland, you are beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I've never been here before. I'm stunned. It's gorgeous. Ooh, there's flies on my camera. Get off. You want to be in the, you can be in the shot, but just go away. Put it on the camera. Sit. Got wildlife all over wanting to be in the shot. Don't mind him being in the shot, I just don't want to be right on the middle of the shot. They seem to have a fascination with this camera. Don't know what it is. Yeah. Again, it's this one's even more peaceful if I just stop. It's just nothingness. Not even the babble of the river like we had earlier. It's just absolute nothingness. Perfect for a retreat, really. So I think I picked the right spot to have my little holiday retreat. But yeah, I'm kind of glad that I've pushed myself on this extra bit of walk. This is when it takes me like 3 hours longer than it should to get home, and I'm getting back at like 10, but well, we'll see. So I take it this area is obviously really well stocked with Christmas trees, because look, there's like loads. It's a beautiful little clearing there. But yeah, absolutely loads of fir trees. No, pine trees, pine needles. Oh. So there's loads of them about. So they're obviously really well off Christmas trees here. So if you want a good Christmas tree, just come up to Scotland. Oh my god, saying that. About to walk into some absolutely massive ones. I don't actually know which way I'm supposed to go. I've reached a bit of a decision. Just come from this way, and I can't see any more. Well, I can see a pillar up here, but I don't know where whether I'm supposed to go this way. So I can see the back of it. So if it's got a little boar on the front of it, maybe I go this way. I don't know. Look, there's no little boar on the back. Look. There is a little boar on the front. Okay. The question is, have I already come this way? I don't think I have actually. Or did I loop up and round? I have no idea. I'm lost. Not hard for me. I'm lost. Well, I'll carry on this one. If it takes us round the same bit again, I've done the same bit again. Oh well. I think I went up this way. Yeah, we'll see. It's pretty. I don't know that I have, because it's quite open. Like more open than the rest of it. And that says Quarry Keep Out, Forestry Civil Engineering. So I've come the wrong way. Which I mean I'm misled by those boar signs. Anyway, head back down. Sun's out as well. Don't you see? Lovely sun out now. Yeah, we'll head back down. Over the other way, the turning.
But you don't know if you don't try, so came and tried. Apparently can't go this way. Yeah, and I've taken a path where I'm not quite sure where I'm going, but I picked the one, as always, the best views. I was intrigued, I wasn't quite sure what was down this way. So we'll have a look. Seems to be not a lot of signpostage on this particular walk. It did say it was signed. It did say in all my information and things back at the cottage that it was all signposted and it was all, you should be able to see exactly where you're going, but all I keep seeing is that Forestry Commission one. And I've only spotted one bit where it says you can't go. Other than that, it's all been pretty fair game, so I could be still here in the middle of the night wandering around, because actually I've thought I was going, now I'm going downhill, thought I was actually heading back, but it wouldn't seem like I'm doing that quite yet. I am actually a little bit concerned now because I can't see Loch Tay anywhere anymore. And I know that we were right on the edge of it, so where I started was literally just off the edge of it. So hopefully it appears and I can then get my bearings, know where I am. Because at the moment I don't actually know, because if it's that way I should have gone on the other path. If it's this way then I'm going on the right one, and I'm thankful I didn't go on the wrong path. But I can't even see any water right now. Looking down over the sides I can see a road, that's it. I can see fields. So I'm hoping I'm actually heading towards Loch Tay. Hoping for the best, really. It's pretty. It's very pretty, though. Bit of an adventure. I'm not quite sure whether I've walked round the mountain or up the mountain or quite what I've done either. So, yeah, this could be fun. Oh my god, so you can only just about see it, but that is the end of a rainbow. I'm so excited, it's right. Oh, can you see my finger? Where's my finger? Here. Right, just along here. It's a rainbow, we found the end of a rainbow! It's not Ireland, so there's not pot gold at the end, unfortunately. But I'm so amazed to see one down on the ground. It's not very clear. I'm so sorry it's not very clear. When you're looking at it, you can actually see it. Oh, it's gone. It's going. But it's because at the moment it is raining and it's sunny at the same time. So, I think it's gone now. It was so prominent when I first saw it. It's amazing. Yeah, it's gone now. Yeah, saw a rainbow! I can see the clearing. Well, I can see our clearing. Hopefully. We'll have to see, but hopefully that is going to reveal if I've gone the right way or not. I'm hoping it's the right way. I don't really want to turn back. Do you know what? Even if I can't see the lock, I'm going to just keep going this way, and if I get to the bottom, can't find where I am, then I'll just have to correct it somehow, but I'll do it from the bottom, not from up a hill. I'm not heading back up. And no visible sign of a lock, just fields, more and more fields. I'm hoping behind those pylons, maybe you can see them in the distance. And we're still going downhill, it's a good sign. I'm hoping eventually that the other side of those bushes, it's the lock, car park. Yeah, I still don't know where I'm going, but I'm going to stick with this route and just see where I end up. Keep saying that. I mean, there's lovely scenery. Definitely getting a scenic route. With no signs or anything, I'm just lost. Little bit is
beginning to look familiar. I say that could be in the completely wrong spot. Fairly sure, I'm just going to keep going down. Fairly sure we came up around that bit at one point. No, maybe not. This is looking a little bit different now. Nope. Still don't know where I am. Being hopeful at the end of this path, or just at the bottom, I saw a car go past, and I can hear more cars. I'm getting closer to at least the bottom, if not where I'm supposed to be, at least the bottom. I had to come through a gate just up around the corner there, so I'm pretty sure I'm not on anybody's private property. I'm sure it would have said if I was, it would have been like private or something. So thankfully I didn't have to turn back, and there was walking path around the gate. It was just a no cars gate as far as I could see. I can hear the traffic in the background. I'm just hoping that this is the right way. Okay, this actually brings me back to the car park. Looking clearer through the trees, you can see road. See, that side's still forest, but it's looking more promising. Nope, just looks like I'm out on a road. Roads comes road signs, so hopefully that means I can find the right way back. I still don't know what route I've taken. I don't think I've done the designated walk, if I'm perfectly honest, but yeah, hopefully we can find the right. Keep my eye out for some road signs now. Tell me which way I'm supposed to go. Oh, so I went into Peeler Gate, apparently the Forestry Commission Scotland Peeler Gate. Means nothing to me. Oh, so I went into Peeler Gate. Apparently the Forestry Commission Scotland Peeler Gate. Means nothing to me. But it's where I went. Find out where I went. Oh, so I went into Peeler Gate. Apparently the Forestry Commission Scotland Peeler Gate. Means nothing to me. But it's where I went. Find out where I went. Hopefully this now means I'm on the way back. It does say Aberfeldy 6 the other way, which is good because the little town that I've come to is 6 miles down from Aberfeldy. So it's promising. I'm still not 100% sure where I am. At least I seem to be back on the right sort of path, I think. So thanks to a lovely gentleman that helped me, I think I've almost found my way back to where I need to be. I certainly found myself on signs again for the Drummond Hill Pass. Just come across this little castle though. But I still no idea where I am. I turned off at that pretty little castle to see, because it said about the hill walks, and I'm just walking along the road because I thought actually I'm not going up into the hill there. Because I'll never get back down. So I thought, oh, that's alright. I'll just walk along the road until I find the car park. Ah, hallelujah. Drummond Hill. That's the car park I came in on. So I've just got up this hill. Up this hill should be my car. If it's not, I'm going to cry. I'm actually going to break down in tears, I think. But yeah. Oh, nothing like a little bit of stress for what should have been a nice relaxing walk. It's my own fault. I should have stuck with the viewpoint and gone home. And I didn't, did I? I decided to go further. But I think finally I found my car. So as you might have gathered, I have made it back. Finally got to the car, finally got home. Yeah. And I've booked myself into the spa, so I'm in to have a hot stone treatment later in the week.
Bliss. So yeah, I'm going to end the vlog here. I've got an evening ahead of, I think, drinking rosé and vlog editing. Nice chilled evening. Might watch a bit of a YouTube to catch up. There's still a few people I follow who haven't caught up with all the stuff, especially when I was away in France. I didn't get a chance to watch all of the, catch up on all the videos I like to watch. So yeah, I will see you soon. So give this a like if you like what you see, subscribe if you feel like it, and I will see you tomorrow.